أهل الإسلام، وجلت وعظمت مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات، فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت، ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم عن مقامكم وأزالتكم عن مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها، ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم، ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم، برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم ومن أشياعهم وأتباعهم وأوليائهم يا أبا عبد الله، إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم إلى يوم القيامة، ولعن الله آل زياد وآل مروان، ولعن الله بني أمية قاطبة، ولعن الله ابن مرجانة، ولعن الله عمر بن سعد، ولعن الله شمرا، ولعن الله أمة أسرجت وألجمت وتنقبت لقتالك. بأبي أنت وأمي لقد عظم مصابي بك، فأسأل الله الذي أكرم مقامك وأكرمني بك أن يرزقني طلب ثارك مع إمام منصور من أهل بيت محمد صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم اجعلني عندك وجيها بالحسين عليه السلام في الدنيا والآخرة. يا أبا عبد الله، إني أتقرب إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى أمير المؤمنين وإلى فاطمة وإلى الحسن وإليك بموالاتك وبالبراءة ممن قاتلك ونصب لك الحرب، وبالبراءة ممن أسس أساس الظلم والجور عليكم، وأبرأوا إلى الله وإلى رسوله صلى الله عليه وآله ممن أسس أساس ذلك وبنى عليه بنيانه وجرى في ظلمه وجوره عليكم وعلى أشياعكم. برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم وأتقرب إلى الله ثم إليكم بموالاتكم وموالاة وليكم وبالبراءة من أعدائكم والناصبين لكم الحرب، وبالبراءة من أشياعهم وأتباعهم، إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم وولي لمن والاكم وعدو لمن عاداكم. فأسأل الله الذي أكرمني بمعرفتكم ومعرفة أوليائكم ورزقني البراءة من أعدائكم أن يجعلني معكم في الدنيا والآخرة، وأن يثبت لي عندكم قدم صدق في الدنيا والآخرة، وأسأله أن يبلغني المقام المحمود لكم عند الله، وأن يرزقني طلب ثاري مع إمام هدى ظاهر ناطق بالحق منكم. وأسأل الله بحقكم وبالشأن الذي لكم عنده أن يعطيني بمصابي بكم أفضل ما يعطي مصابا بمصيبته، مصيبة ما أعظمها وأعظم رزيتها في الإسلام وفي جميع السماوات والأرض. اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا ممن تناله منك صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة. اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد، ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إن هذا يوم تبركت به بنو أمية وابن آكلة الأكباد، اللعين ابن اللعين على لسانك ولسان نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله في كل موطن وموقف وقف فيه نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم لعن أبا سفيان ومعاوية ويزيد ابن معاوية عليهم منك اللعنة أبد الآبدين. وهذا يوم فرحت به آل زياد وآل مروان بقتلهم الحسين صلوات الله عليه. اللهم فضاعف عليهم اللعن منك والعذاب الأليم. اللهم إني أتقرب إليك في هذا اليوم وفي موقفي هذا وأيام حياتي بالبراءة منهم واللعنة عليهم وبالموالاة لنبيك وآل نبيك عليه وعليهم السلام. اللهم لعن أول ظالم ظلم حق محمد وآل محمد، وآخر تابع له على ذلك. اللهم لعن العصابة التي جاهدت الحسين وشايعت وبايعت وتابعت على قتله، اللهم لعنهم جميعا. مئة السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك، عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت، وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. مئة مرة. اللهم خص أنت أول ظالم باللعن مني، وابدأ به أولا، ثم العن الثانية والثالثة والرابع. اللهم العن يزيد خامسا، والعن عبيد الله بن زياد وابن مرجان وعمر بن سعد وشمرا وآل أبي سفيان وآل زياد وآل مروان إلى يوم القيامة. سجود. اللهم لك الحمد حمد الشاكرين لك على مصابهم الحمد لله على عظيم رزيتي، اللهم ارزقني شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود، وثبِّت لي قدم صدقٍ عندك مع الحسين وأصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا مهجهم دون الحسين عليه السلام، ولأرواح جميع شيعة أمير المؤمنين، لا سيما أموات المشاهدين والمستمعين. رحم الله من قرأ سورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها صلوات لأعلى الأصوات. اللهم صل على محمد.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أعظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بشهادة المولى أبي عبد الله الحسين بمصابنا بأبي عبد الله الحسين. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الطالبين بثأره مع الإمام المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه الشريف. صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله. The day of sorrow, the day of tragedy on the heart of صاحب العصر والزمان. What is the state of our Imam on this day? If his daily routine is to cry blood instead of tears of Abi Abdullah al-Hussein, what would be his state on this day? Sayyidi ya sahib al-asr wa al-zaman, today we are here in order to shed tears with you. What is the value of this tea? Why do we shed these tears? Learning about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi weeping over Abi Abdullah al-Hussein 60 years before he was martyred, this makes us wonder, what is the value of this tea? Why do we cry for Abi Abdullah al-Hussein salawatullahi wa salam alayhi? And what is the value of the tea that we shed over Abi Abdullah al-Hussein? When Al-Imam al-Sadiq was asked about the rewards that we get from this tea, he said, ma la yuhsa, what's uncountable. This tea is the sign of the mu'min. This tea will extinguish the fire of hell that we throw ourselves in. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam says, إِذَا سَالَ دَمْعُهُ عَلَىٰ خَدَّيْهِ فَلَوْ أَنَّ قَطْرَ وَاحِدَ. If one drop of these tears would be dropped in the hellfire, it would extinguish the hellfire as if there is no fire at all. This tea is the reason behind the mercies that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends upon the mu'mineen. Imam al-Sadiq says that before the tea comes out of the eye, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon that person. Imam al-Sadiq speaks to Musmi' when he asked him about, do you shed tears over Imam al-Husayn? He said, yes. He said, أَمَا إِنَّكَ يَا مُسْمِعْ أَمَا إِنَّكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ يُعَدُّونَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَزَعِ. You are considered one of those who are sad whenever we are sad, and happy whenever we are happy, and scared whenever we are scared. Ya Musmi', because of that tea, my parents and my ancestors, Amir al-Mu'mineen wa Rasulullah wa Fatimah al-Zahra wa al-Hasan wa al-Husayn, they will attend your deathbed and they will speak to the angel of death so he can be mercy over you. He can be merciful with you. And he will be merciful with you better than the mercy of the mother with her child. And this tea is the reason behind forgiving our sins. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, whoever mentions us, or when we are mentioned in front of him, a tea that comes out of his eye the size of the fly's wing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe his sins, even if it was the same amount as the foam of the waves of the sea. Sallallahu alayka ya Mawlaya ya Rasulallah. صلى الله عليك وعلى آل بيتك المعصومين المظلومين لعن الله الظالمين لكم سادتي من الأولين والآخرين صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله يا غريب يا مظلوم كربلاء سيدي يا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما. With these tears that we shed today, we condole the heart of Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra. Du'bul al-Khuza'i, the poet who was remembering Abi Abdullah al-Husayn in front of Imam al-Rida alayhi salam, in some of the verses speaking to Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra, he says, أفاطم لو خلت الحسين مجدلا وقد مات عطشانا بشط فراتي، إذا للطمت الخد فاطم عنده وأجريت دمع العين في الوجنات. أو فاطمة، if you see Imam al-Hussein slaughtered beside the river thirsty, you will weep and cry over him and you will struck your cheeks. In this poem, Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra replies back to Du'bul. She says, أدعبل شاهدت الحسين مجدلا وكانت دموع العين ماء فراتي، أتيت إليه رغم كسر بأضلعي، أجر ذيول الحزن بالعثرات. Oh, Du'bul, I saw the body of Imam al-Hussein slaughtered. And I didn't only cry tears. My tears were the amount of the water of Euphrates. And I came despite my broken rib. And I came towards Abi Abdullah al-Hussein. هويت بلطم الرأس للخد عنده ولطخت من قان الدماء وجنا. Instead of striking my cheeks, I struck my head, but I dyed my cheeks with his blood. من الوالدة من الوالدة والقلب لهفان لهفان ودور عزبني وين ما كان أويلي على ابن المات عطشان ولعبت عليه الخيل ميدان. السلام على من نكثت ذمته، السلام على من هتكت حرمته، السلام على من أريق بالظلم دمه، السلام على المغسل بدم الجراح. Peace be upon the bereaved and patient one. Peace be upon the oppressed who was without a helper. Salam upon the one whose rights and dignity were violated. Salam upon the one whose sanctity was desecrated. Salam upon the one whose blood was unjustly shed. Salam upon the one who was bathed in the blood with his wounds. With the dawn of the 10th of Muharram, Hussein, the grandson of the Prophet of Islam, led his followers for the dawn prayer. He then wore his grandfather's armor and turban and put on his father's sword and stood to address his small band of followers. He began by praising Allah and his Prophet. He then declared to his followers, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَىٰ قَدْ أَذِنَ فِي قَتْلِي وَقَتْلِكُمْ فِي هَذَا الْيَوْمِ فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالصَّبْرِ وَالْقِتَالِ. Allah has willed that you and I shall be killed today, so be strong and steadfast. The Imam rode on his grandfather's horse and began preparing for war as his companions mobilized for battle. The army of Umar bin Sa'd encircled the tents of Hussein. Shimr attempted to approach the camp from behind, only to find a moat filled with fire blocking him. So he screamed, "Oh Hussein, you have hurried to the hellfire." Hussein replied, "You are more deserving of the hellfire." Muslim bin Awsaja wanted to shoot an arrow in Shimr's direction, but Hussein stopped him, saying, "I hate to be the one to start the war." On the other side, Umar bin Sa'd, the commander of the enemy's army, had come with no less than 30,000 troops. When Imam al-Hussein saw their gathering, which resembled a mighty torrent, he raised his hands to the heavens and prayed, Allahumma anta thiqati fi kulli karb, wa anta raja'i fi kulli shidda, wa anta li fi kulli amrin nazala bi thiqatun wa udda. My Lord, You are my haven in every mishap, my hope in every predicament, my refuge and defender in every ordeal. How many a distress that weakens the heart makes the enemy rejoice at the misfortune when I entrusted it to you and resorted to you out of preference over others. You did not let me down, and had driven away and eliminated all these distressing things. You are the giver of every boon and the ultimate source of every wish to be granted. Umar bin Sa'd, la'anallah, the commander of the enemy camp, then drew nearer to the camp of Husayn and ordered the bearer of the flag to move forward. He took an arrow, placed it in his arch, and shot at Husayn's camp, saying, "Bear witness for me with the ruler that I was the first to shoot." The arrows then followed like rain, causing injuries to every single one of Husayn's men. Imam al-Husayn then called on his followers, "Qumu rahimakumullah ila al-maut alladhi la budda minh. Hadhihi as-siham rusulul qawmi ilaykum." Rise to the inevitable death. May God bestow His mercy upon you. These arrows are the messengers of these people to you. Husayn's men waged a fierce battle in defense of their leader. When the dust settled, 50 of them lie dead on the sand. When Husayn saw this tragic scene, he began pleading for help. Ala hal min nasirin yansuruna, ala hal min mu'inin yu'inuna, ala min dhabin yadhubbu an harami rasulillah. Is there no helper to help us? Is there no one to protect the sanctity of the Prophet's women and children? When the woman heard his plea, the sound of their wailing and sobbing rose in the camp. One by one, the companions of Husayn came forward and asked for his blessings and permission to go fight, bidding him farewell. Then the companions proceeded to defend the son of the messenger and were killed one after the other. But before they were killed, they used to tell each other to look after Abi Abdullah al-Husayn and to defend al-Husayn Aba Abdullah. Once all of the companions were killed, the family of Imam al-Husayn prepared for battle. The first to come forward was Ali al-Akbar, Husayn's 17-year-old son. When Ali asked for his father's permission, tears began pouring out of Husayn's eyes. نظر إليه نظرة آيس من وأرخى عيني عليه السلام وبكى ثم رفع شيبته الشريفة نحو السماء وقال اللهم اشهد على هؤلاء القوم فقد برز إليهم غلام أشبه الناس خلقا وخلقا ومنطقا برسولك. O God, be witness against these people, for a young man has been forced to face them who has the closest resemblance to your Prophet in his nature, manners and his speech. Whenever we yearn for your messenger, we would look at his face. O Lord, deprive them from the riches of the land, divide them, and bring your wrath upon them. He then turned to Umar bin Sa'd. He said, وَيْلَكَ يَا عُمَرُ قَطَعَ اللَّهُ رَحِمَكَ كَمَا قَطَعْتَ رَحِمِي. Woe unto you, Umar ibn Sa'd. May God sever your lineage just as you have severed mine. Ali al-Akbar entered the battlefield, killing dozens of enemy troops while reciting the epic, أَنَا عَلِيُّ بْنُ الْحُسَيْنِ بْنِي عَلِيِّ تَاللَّهِ لَا يَحْكُمُ فِينَ بْنُ الدَّعِيِّ أَضْرِبُ بِالسَّيْفِ أُحَامِي عَنْ نَبِيِّ ضَرْبَ غُلَامٍ هَاشِمِيٍّ عَلَوِيِّ. I am Ali, son of Hussein, son of Ali. We are by God closer to the Prophet. The unbearable thirst, the scorching sun, and the painful wounds of those swords soon forced Ali al-Akbar to retreat to his camp. Asking his father for a drink, Husayn told him the pain would soon be over, saying, "It is only a matter of time before your grandfather quenches your thirst with his eternal cup." Ali al-Akbar went back, fighting with great avail. It was as if his grandfather, Imam Ali, was in the battlefield. Finally, while Ali al-Akbar was fighting, Murr bin Munqidh al-Abdi alayhi la'inullah approached him, raising his hands up high, raising his sword, and dealt a blow to Ali's head, causing him to fall on his horse. His blood began gushing from his sacred head and covered the horse's face. His horse, not being able to see, led Ali to the enemy's camp. The troops attacked him from all the directions. Thousands began striking him with their swords. فَقَطَّعُوهُ إِرَبًا إِرَبًا. They cut him into pieces. Aywa Aliya. Upon his death, Ali al-Akbar screamed so his father could hear him. Aba alayka min as-salam. O father, farewell. Fahadha jaddi Rasulullah qad saqani bi ka'si al-awfa. He offered his grieving father consolation. Here is my grandfather from whose cup I have drunk. Never again will I be thirsty. He says that there will be a cup waiting for you. Imam al-Husayn rushed to him, seeing what is remaining from his son Ali. He threw himself from the horse onto his son. He put his cheeks on Ali's cheeks and said, Bunay Ali ala al-dunya ba'daka al-afa. ما أجرأهم على الرحمن وعلى انتهاك حرمة الرسول. قعد عنده وشافهم غمض العين بدم سابحهم ترب الخدين متواصل طبور والراس نصين حين ظهر على ابني وتحسر. حسين sobbed aloud, drawing attention from the enemy who had not seen him cry like that. Imam al-Husayn then ordered the youth to come carry Ali back to the camp. The women gathered around Ali, weeping, crying, beating their heads. Betrayed and helpless, Hussein began pleading for help. When his cries were heard, even the children answered his call. The orphan of Imam al-Hassan, 13-year-old Qasim, went to his uncle. At first, Imam al-Husayn refused to give him permission, but Qasim pleaded with his uncle, kissing his hands and feet, begging for his blessings. فَتَعَانَقَاهُ وَبَكَيَا سَاعَ. The Imam hugged Qasim and wept, and then allowed him to go. When he faced the army of Yazid, al-Qasim fought bravely, saying, إِن تُنْكِرُونِي فَأَنَا نَجْلُ الْحَسَنِ سبط النبي المصطفى والمؤتمن هذا حسين كالأسير المرتغن بين أناس لا سقوا صوب المزن. If you do not know me, I am the son of Hassan, grandson of the Prophet, the chosen one. This is Hussein, who is held like a hostage among people who show no mercy. The young boy fought bravely, killing many soldiers at his tender age, until his sandal snapped on his left foot as he bent down to fix it. Umar ibn Sa'd al-Azdi came from his back, holding his sword up high, struck him with his sword on his head. He cried out, Aghithni ya amma, uncle, save me. Imam al-Husayn rushed to him, crying over his body, saying in a painful voice, عز والله على عمك أن تدعوه فلا يجيبك أو يجيبك ثم لا يعينك أو يعينك فلا يغني عنك. صوت والله ك وكر رواتره وقل ناصره. It is painful for your uncle that you'd call him, but he can't respond, or he responds but he can't help you, and he helps you but he can't benefit you. اللهم احصهم عددا ولا ترضي الولاة عنهم أبدا. يا ابني يا جاسم جيت أشمك وبدمعي أغسل جروح جسمك. Qasim was brought back to the tent. They put his body next to the body of Ali al-Akbar and the other youth. Jaba umaddida ma binukhudam وبيتشا عيدهم يا ولي وهم موتى لما انسمعني النسوان صوتى اجت رملة تصيح الله أكبر.
Al-Qasim has left, Ali al-Akbar left, when Abbas saw the death toll rising, he stood up and ordered his brother Abdullah, Uthman and Ja'far to enter the battlefield and fight for the brother and Master Hussein, Abbas's brothers, children of Ali and Umm al-Baneen, fought valiantly and embraced death one by one. It was now time for Abbas himself to enter the battle. He came to his brother Hussein seeking permission to go. Hussein couldn't be the to lose his brother, couldn't bear to lose his brother. Tears filled his eyes. Abbas, you are the bearer of my flag. If you die, my entire army will collapse and my enemies will rejoice. Abbas replied, I am tired of these hypocrites. I cannot bear to hear sounds of the children crying of thirst. I wish to seek my revenge. Sahih siyan ya khuya ya Abbas ya nuri al يا تاجي على الراس يا خويا انت الدريع والسيف والطاس شلون تروح وانا بقى محير. When Hussein saw Abbas adamant to fight, he said, if you must then go and seek some water for these children. Abbas mounted his horse, he took the water container and headed towards the river, cutting through the enemy lines. He was surrounded by 4,000 troops who shot at him with their arrows, but he did not fear their multitudes. The standard hoisted over his head, he started attacking them until they all fled. He managed to reach the river while overwhelmed with water. As soon as he reached the water, the enemy said, if he quenches his thirst, it will be the end of us. But Abbas threw the water back into the stream without drinking. He filled the container and walked out. No one knew why he did that. They then heard him saying, Ya nafsu min ba'd al-Husayn huni وبعده لا كنت أن تكوني هذا حسين وارد المنون وتشربين بارد المعين. Abbas, he's talking to himself, you are worthless after Hussein. It makes no difference whether you live or die. Here is Hussein dying of thirst while you drink from the cool stream. Abbas would never drink while Hussein and the children were still thirsty. He filled his water sack, mounted his horse again, and headed towards the camp. Bent on blocking his path, enemy troops surrounded him from every direction. Thousands attacked him all at once. Zayd ibn al-Ruqad wa Hakim ibn al-Tufail were hiding behind the tree.
waiting for Abbas to approach. Zayd struck Abbas on his right arm, cutting it off. Abbas cried out, Wallahi in qata'tumu yamini. إني أحامي أبداً عن ديني وعني ما من صادق اليقين. By God, if you cut off my hand, I will forever defend my faith. I shall protect my master, the grandson of the Holy Prophet. He grabbed the sword with his left arm, continuing to fight while he headed towards the camp with the water container. Suddenly, Hakim emerged from behind the tree and stuck his left arm, severing it. Abbas cried, Ya nafsu la takhshay min al-kuffari wa abshiri bi rahmatil jabbari qad qata'u bi baghyim yasari faslim ya rabbu harran nari. He managed to grab the water skin in his teeth, staying without his two arms. He headed towards the camp, but they did not give him a chance. They showered him with arrows. One pierced his container, spilling the water. Another arrow pierced through his chest. Another arrow struck his eye. فوقف العباس متحيرا. He was confused, didn't know what to do anymore. He doesn't have hands to go back to the tent. He doesn't have hands to go and fill the water. And he doesn't have water to go back to the tent. As he stood in despair, a wicked man came to him. He said, You are Abbas? You are the hero of Imam al-Hussein? Al-Abbas said, Did you come now to me? Well, I have no hands. He said, Oh Abbas, if you have no hands and I have hands. Then he struck the head of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas with a metal bone. Then Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas fell on the ground. He cried, Akhi adrik akhak. Brother, come to your brother. Imam al-Hussein rushed to him, causing the enemy troops to flee and saying, Ila ayna tafirun waqad qataltum akhi. Where do you flee when you have killed my brother? When Hussein approached him, he first saw the water skin, then the standard lying on the ground. Then he saw the two arms of Al-Abbas scattered on the battlefield. Abbas lied on the sands, an arrow planted deep in his eye, another in his chest. Imam al-Hussein cried out, Akhi Aba al-Fadl. الآن انكسر ظهري الآن شمت بي عدوي يا أخويا انكسر ظهري ولا أقدر أقوم وصرت مركز يا خويا الكل الهموم يا خويا استوحدوني عقبك القوم ولا واحد بعد علي ينغار. عباس, my back is now broken. عباس, my enemy has rejoiced over your death. عباس, there is no one to support me any longer. عباس, who will safeguard the daughters of the Prophet after you? Hussein then went back to the camp alone, heartbroken, sorrowful, hopeless, weeping, wiping his tears with his shirt sleeve. Sukaina approached and asked him about her uncle. Zainab asked, Where is our brother Abbas? Hussein didn't say a word. He simply headed towards Abbas's dad, removed its pillar, letting it fall, meaning that Abbas was martyred. Zainab screamed, Wa dhay'atana ba'daka ya Abul Fadl. Al-Imam Hussein joined them saying, wa dhay'atana ba'dak, we are lost after you, O Abul Fadl. Allahu Akbar. After the death of Abbas, Imam Hussein was left without supporters. He looked around and saw nothing but dead bodies around him. He kept on shouting, Hal min nasirin yansuruna? Is there no one to help us? We say, Labbaik Aba Abdullah. Labbaik Ya Hussein. Is there no one to protect us? Before Imam Hussein said his last farewell, he asked his sister Zainab to bring him his infant Abdullah, who was just 6 months old. When he saw how the child was dying of thirst, Hussein took his child and headed towards the enemy and screamed, Ya Qawm, qad qataltum akhi wa awladi wa ansari wa ma baqiya ghayru hadha al-tifl wa huwa yatalazza atasha min ghayri dhanbin ataahu ilaykum fasquhu shurbatan min al-ma. He said, O people, you have killed my brothers, my sons, and my supporters, and I have no one left but this child. The milk in his mother's breast has dried up. If you show no mercy to me, then have mercy on him, for he is dying of thirst. He has committed no crime, so give him a drink of water. The enemy was split. A few said, this is but an infant, let us quench his thirst. Others said, لا تبقوا لأهل هذا البيت من باقية. Do not let any member of this house survive. Some of them even said, إن كان للرجال ذنب فما ذنب هذا الرضيع. If the men have committed a crime, what is the crime of this suckling infant? Fearing to send an insurrection in his camp, Umar sought the help of his lead archer. He said, put an end to this dispute, O Harmala. Harmala knew what his commander was asking of him. Allahu Akbar. Imagine this situation. 6 months old baby with his desperate father. Immediately, Harmala took an arrow and put it in the arch, and he shot the infant with a three-pronged poisoned arrow, an arrow designed to hunt desert beasts. The child's neck was too delicate for such an arrow. It severed his head from the jugular vein to the jugular vein. The infant fluttered for a movement in his father's hands, his blood gushing from his tiny jugular vein before wilting and freezing. As Hussein looked while crying in shock, Hussein said, هَوَّنَ مَا نَزَلَ بِي أَنَّهُ بِعَيْنِ اللَّهِ. What makes this bearable is that it is in the sight of God. The father then scooped the blood of his son. Hussein threw the child's blood throat to the sky. Ilahi, in kana hadha yurdik, fakhudh hatta tarda. O Lord, if this pleases you, then take until you are pleased. He cried in submission. Imam al-Baqir says, not a drop of their blood came back to the ground. Hussein then took the slaughtered child to the camp. Zainab came to welcome her nephew, only to see the child in Hussein's arm with his throat slashed. Hussein then went behind the tent, his clothes drenched with the blood of his thirsty boy. He dug a miniature grave with the tip of his sword, then buried him in his blood-soaked garment. As-salamu ala Abdullah ibn al-Husayn al-tifl al-radhi'. Peace be upon Abdullah, the infant, the one who was left for dead, fluttering in his blood, raised to the heave, the one slaughtered with the arrow in his father's arms. May Allah curse Haram. ارمله شام يا الجنيت بالظلمه تلالي عقبك بوقت وحش الليالي انا دورا عن يميني وعن شمالي اهز بالمهد والمهد خالي. The mother of Abdullah الرضيع is saying that I shake the cradle while it's empty. Imam was now alone. He had no choice but to charge at the enemy by himself. He is described as such. كان آيسا من الحياة. He had lost all hope in this life. He attacked the right flank while saying, الموت أولى من ركوب العار والعار أولى من دخول النار. Death is better than being humiliated, and being humiliated is better than entering hellfire. He attacked the left flank while saying, أنا الحسين بن علي آليت ألا أنثني أحمي عيالات أبي أمضي على دين النبي. I am Hussein, son of Ali. I vow not to bow down. I am defending my family. I follow the religion of the Prophet. Abdullah bin Ammar says, I have never seen a bereaved and grief-stricken man who has witnessed the murder of all of his children and companions, bearing the sorrow of all the calamities, yet is more steadfast, brave, and courageous than Hussein, so much so that no one dared stand in his way. Hussein challenged the enemy to come and fight with him. Whoever came forward to confront him was sent to hell by Hussein's sword. Many of them were left dead. So Umar said, احملوا عليه من كل جانب. Ibn Sa'd rallied his troops saying, attack him from all directions. Thousands of enemy troops launched collective attacks against Hussein. He responded to all of them such that they fled from him like a flock of goats flee from a wolf. Having failed, the enemy decided to pursue another strategy. The archers shot 4,000 arrows towards him, and he was prevented from reaching his women and children. Hussein shouted, woe unto you, O followers of the family of Abu Sufyan. If you have no religion and do not fear the afterlife, then at least be free and noble in your word. And you are, if you are Arabs, then return to your race. Shamr yelled, O son of Fatima, what are you saying? Hussein replied, I say I am fighting you and you are fighting me. It is no fault of the women. So until I am alive, keep your people away from my family. Shamr said, we will give you that, and ordered him to focus their attack on Hussein. He returned to his camp one last time. He called out, Ya Sukaina, Ya Rabab, Ya Zainab, Hada Akhirul Wada'. O Rabab, O Sakina, O Zainab, may peace be with you. This is the last farewell. قوموا إلى التوديع إن أخي دعا بجوادي إن الفراق طويل فخرجنا ربات الخدور حواسرا وغدا لهن حول الحسين عويل. The women gathered around him and started wailing and sobbing aloud. We shall meet in paradise. Be patient after my death. You have many tragedies awaiting you. Then he asked for his horse. Allahu Akbar. Imam al-Hussein, usually when he asked for his horse, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas comes and give it to him. Oh, al-Qasim comes and give it to him. His son Ali al-Akbar, one of the companions. This time he says, من ذا يقدم لي جواد المنية ولا حمان وكفيل زينب
زينب عليه السلام كيم الذهوس سيئ ما أجلدني وما أقسى قلبي، أي أخت تقدم لأخيها جواد المنية ولاحما وكفيل. Zainab brought him his horse. He mounted it. As he was about to leave, he heard a faint voice calling from his behind, Mahlan Mahla, Ya Ibn al-Zahra. He looked back. His sister asked him to alight from his horse. She needs to do something. Zainab embraces her brother. She kisses his throat and chest, and she faces towards Al-Baqi' and said, Mother, I did as you told me. لقد استرجعت الوديعة. Al-Imam Al-Husayn asked, What is that, Zainab? She said, When my mother was on her deathbed, she told me, When you see your brother Al-Husayn alone in Karbala, smell him in his neck, kiss him on his chest, because his chest is where the hooves will run. And the neck is the where the swords will hit. Allahu Akbar. She did that. Al-Imam Al-Husayn proceeded to the battlefield, confronted with an army of 30,000. He looked right and left, searching for helpers only to find his companions slain like sacrificial lambs. نظر يمينا وشمالا فلم ير إلا من صافح التراب جبينه وقطع الحمام أنين حمام أنينه فنادى يا أبطال الصفا ويا فرسان الهيجا. O heroes of the battlefield, O knights of warfare, ما لأناديكم فلا تجيبون وأدعوكم فلا تسمعون أنيام أنتم أرجوكم تنتبهون. I call unto you, but you do not answer. If you're asleep, I beseech you to wake up. هذه نساء الرسول لفقدكم قد علاهن الذهول والنحول فقوموا عن نومتكم أيها الكرام وادفعوا عن حرم الرسول الطغاة اللئام. These are the women of the Prophet. They have been bereaved for your loss. Please rise, O noble ones, and protect the progeny of the Prophet from the wicked tyrant. Allahu Akbar. Then he called, Ya Habib, Ya Zuhair, Ya Nafi', Ya Muslim ibn Awsaja. He called out their names with a heart-wrenching voice, O Habib, O Muslim bin Awsaja, O Zuhair, O Nafi'. When the children and women heard this, they cried and wailed. So he repeated his plea, Is there not a protector who can defend the sanctity of the Prophet? Is there not a believer who may fear God of that which is befalling us? هل من ناصر ينصرنا. The intense crying of the women and children reached a new peak. Hussein's eldest son Sajjad, who was still ill, saw his father covered with blood of Abbas, Qasim, Zuhair, Muslim, and Habib. He suddenly stood up while leaning on a stick and dragging his sword. Hussein shouted, Sister Zainab, take him back, lest the earth becomes devoid of the progeny of Muhammad. احبسيه لألا ينقطع نسل آل محمد. Imam Sajjad said, How can I not go when my father is all alone? Then the Imam challenged the enemy to come and fight with him. Then whoever came forward to confront him was sent to hell by Hussein's sword. The enemy continuously launched collective attacks on him. He responded to all of them. As a result of his counterattacks, they fled from him like as a flock of goats flee from a lion. Then the Imam would return to his main place and says, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. The Imam fought continuously till the time the enemy separated between him and the women and children. The Imam shouted at them, "Woe unto you, O followers of the family of Abu Sufyan, if you have no religion and do not fear the hereafter and resurrection. Then at least be free and noble in this world, and if you are Arabs, then return to your race." Shimr then ordered his army to target him in person. A fierce fighting raged. Since he was very thirsty, he attacked the flank of the army, which was sealing of the river Euphrates. He managed to disperse them and make his way to the river. Once he was in the water, he extended his hand to drink. A caller shouted, "Do you enjoy drinking water when the sanctity of your family is violated?" He let the water spill from his hands without drinking. He returned to the tents. Hussein turned to his daughter Sukaina, who was sitting in a corner of one tent, crying and lamenting. He stood by her, showing sympathy and solace. سَيَطُولُ بَعْدِي يَا سُكَيْنَةُ فَعْلَمِي مِنْكِ الْبُكَاءِ إِذَا الْحِمَامُ دَانِي لَا تُحْرِقِي قَلْبِي بِدَمْعِكِ حَسْرَةً مَا دَامَ مِنِّ الرُّوحِ فِي جُثْمَانِي Your sorrow will last long after my death, O Sakina. Do not add anguish to my injured heart by crying now that I am alive. But if I am killed, O beloved Sukaina, feel free to cry for ever. Umar bin Sa'd yelled, "Woe unto you! Attack him while he is busy with himself and his family." They charged at him, raining him with arrows. Imam Hussein attacked the enemy like a roaming lion. He received many wounds all over his body, mostly because of the arrows. He returned to his position, repeating the saying, "La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah." Allahu Akbar. He asked for water. Shimr answered, "You are not going to taste it until you enter the hellfire." Another one called him, "Hussein, can you see the waters of the Euphrates flow, moving like the belly of a snake? You are not going to drink from it till you die of thirst." As he was weakened, he paused to rest for a moment. As our Imam was resting, we gaf yestirih hasin sa'a ضعف حالة وثقال بالسيف باع. He paused to rest for a moment. As our Imam was resting, weakened by the thirst and all the wounds and his grief, suddenly a tyrant named Abu al-Hutuf al-Ju'fi hurled a rock at him, hitting his blessed forehead, causing the blood to stream down his face. He grabbed his shirt to wipe the blood from his face. Harmala shot Aba Abdullah with a three-headed arrow, which struck our Imam, piercing his chest straight through his heart. He cried, "Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati Rasulillah." He then raised his hand towards the sky and said, "O Lord, you know full well that they are killing a man. There is not on the face of the earth a son of the daughter of the Prophet. Save him." He pulled out the arrow, causing the blood to gush out. He took a handful of blood and stained his beard, saying, "This is how I want to meet my grandfather." هكذا ألقى الله وألقى جدي رسول الله. Due to the constant attacks, our master Hussein fell to the ground from the back of the horse without lifting his head. A man then approached him, began by cursing him. He then struck Imam al-Hussein with the sword on his head, which was covered with a helmet. The helmet was drenched with blood. He took it off, wrapped his turban on the cap, and said, "May Allah deprive you from eating with your right hand and gather you with the oppressors." Your Imam was now covered with blood. Abdullah, the son of Imam al-Hassan, an 11-year-old boy, saw his uncle surrounded by the enemies. He managed to release his hands from his mother's grip, hurried towards the pit of the pit the Imam al-Hussein was sitting in. He sat on the Imam's lap, looking left and right, when an enemy approached, lifting his sword to kill the Imam. Abdullah called out, "O son of the wicked women, you want to kill my uncle? Ataqtulu ammi ibn al-khabitha?" The boy shielded the Imam with his arm from the stroke of the sword, whereby his hand was cut and began to dangle by the skin. He looked at the Imam saying, "Uncle, they severed my right arm." Al-Imam al-Hussein said to him, "Be patient, you will soon join your father." Harmala then shot an arrow at the boy and killed him while he was in his uncle's lap. وبقي الحسين مطروح على الأرض مليا. Shimr yelled, "Why are you standing like this? The man is critically wounded. Attack him from every angle. From every angle." One man says, "I was standing near Hussein as he was on the brink of dying. By God, I never saw a person getting killed, soaked in his blood, in a better state than Hussein. His face was luminous. I was so overwhelmed by the radiance of his face that I refrained from contemplating killing him." He asked for water. They did not give him any to drink. One said, "I came to kill him. He looked me in the eyes. His eyes were exactly like the eyes of Rasulullah." All of this is happening while Imam al-Hussein is saying, "Wahaq jaddi ana atshan. By my grandfather, I am thirsty." One from amongst the crowd said to him, "You are not going to drink until you enter hellfire. Then you can drink from its boiling water." The Imam replied, I enter unto my grandfather, the messenger of God, and stay with him." Allahu Akbar. Do you have any more tears left? "And complain to him of that which you have done to me and your transgression against me." They became furious at his remarks, as if Allah did not instill a grain of mercy in their hearts. Now Umar bin Sa'd, with a group of soldiers, is approaching the scene as Imam al-Hussein was at the point of death. "Ya mu'minun fahamalu alayhi min kulli janib." Thousands of people have all descended onto the son of Zahra to kill him. A group with spears, a group with swords, a group with rocks. Imam al-Sadiq says, "Kanat wallah al-dharba fawqa al-dharba. والطعن فوق الطعم طعنا." Every stab came on another stab wound, and every strike landed on another strike wound. Allahu Akbar. They came down to Imam al-Hussein. Ibn Shariq hit him on his left shoulder. Hussein bin Numair shot him in his mouth. Another man hit him on his right shoulder. Allahu Akbar. Sinan bin Anas lodged his spear in the area of the collarbone, then in his chest. He then shot him with an arrow in his throat. Another stabbed him in the neck. Zainab alayhi salam came shouted at Umar. She said, "Ayuqtal Abu Abdullah wa anta tanzuru ilayh." Oh Umar, Abu Abdullah is being killed while you watch. He turned his face. Zainab, the daughter of Ali and Zahra, climbed on a cliff to see her brother. ليت السماء أطبقت على الأرض ليت الموت أعدمن الحياة. I wish if the sky falls on us, I wish if the death buries me. She said, ويلكم أما فيكم مسلم. Isn't there any Muslim amongst you? Nobody replied. At that point, Ibn Sa'd ordered the crowd, descend upon him and kill him. اتقل يا شمر ظل دخلي والله لما انشافته وصفقت بديغه. Allahu Akbar. When he called, descend upon the man, احملوا عليه واريحوه. Shimr initiated the attack. He came towards Imam al-Husayn. He kicked him. He sat on his chest. He got hold of this blessed bead. He pulled out his dagger. Allahu Akbar.
على المظلوم وويلي 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 على المظلوم ووي
دمع الفاجعة تسيله واويلي مظلوم ما ظل والي تشكيله واويلي على المظلوم من الفعل تهلقوم واويلي على من الفعل تهلقوم واويلي مظلوم صاحت من مصيبتها واويلي على المظلوم صاحت من مصيبتها واويلي على ذوش حال الفاقد اخوتها واويلي على المن تبدي شكوتها واويلي على المظلوم ذبحوا كل زلمها اليوم واويلي على ذبحوا كل زلمها اليوم واويلي على حسين تصيح يا الوالي واويلي على خويا عاين الحالي واويلي على حسين تصيح يا الوالي واويلي على خويا عاين الحالي واويلي على والله انصاب دلالي واويلي على المظلوم قلب اختك صفى معلوم واويلي قلب اختك صفى معلوم واويلي علي اش حال اختك يا واليها واويلي على المظلوم اش حال اختك يا واليها هو من الشمر يسبيها واويلي على لو بسياطة يأذيها واويلي على وين البلخدر ملزوم واويلي على المظلوم وين البلخدر ملزوم واويلي هي من شافت أبو اليمة واويلي هو جسمه سابح بدمه واويلي على اجت يم نحرة تشتم واويلي على اجت يم نحرة تشتم واويلي على المظلوم وايد قل ريت تقوم واويلي وايد قل ريت تقوم واويلي تحن وما سمع حنها واويلي نوايب فقد صابنها واويلي قطع من الأخو ظنها واويلي على وحزنها على الوجه مرسوم واويلي مظلوم تجري دموع عيناها واويلي وفقد الأهل أذاها واويلي لو عد تربان ولياها واويلي على المظلوم ظلت بالخيام تحوم واويلي على المظلوم واويلي على المظلوم واويلي مظلوم واويلي على المظلوم واويلي على المظلوم لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين ابن علي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين ابن علي، لا إله إلا الله. زينب تنادي وتنتحب ما ظل محامي ولا ولي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين ابن علي، لا إله إلا الله. نعلي عباس مرمي عثرة يا ريت ينهض كافلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين طاح صبط من المهر وبحاله يشمت عاذلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين والدنيا مقلوبة قلب طاح اللي قال الدللي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين والسيف بيدين الشمر من هزه اختض مفصلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين أقبل على حسين بغضب ناوي ذبح خيرة هلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين لحظة وشفت فوق الرمح راس الصبط جن معتلي، لا إله إلا الله اي صحت بألم خويا انقتل يا ريت قبل مقتلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين هالموقف علي صعب مروده من الحنظلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين عصفت عواصف عاتية، عصفت عواصف عاتية بكربلة وما تنجلي، لا إله إلا الله جيت بخجل بين الزلم أبحث على الينغر إلي، لا إله إلا الله طاح الحسين وينك يا خويا بيا كتر ما تدري حرقه ومنزلي، لا إله إلا الله واويلي على العطشان، واويلي على العطشان، واويلي على العطشان، واويلي على العطشان، عطشان واويلي على العطشان، شان واويلي على العطشان. الله الله حسين وين بالسيوف مقطعينه، الله الله حسين وين حينه، الله الله حسين وين بالسيوف مقطعينه طعي اجرك الله يا علي على حسين ولاده، اجرك الله يا علي على حسين أجرك الله يا علي على حسين ولاده، أجرك الله يا علي ولاده. هاليوم هاليوم نعزي فاطمة، هاليوم هاليوم نعزي هاليوم هاليوم نعزي فاطمة، يوم هاليوم أبد والله يا زهراء ما ننسى حسينا، أبد والله يا زهراء أبد والله يا زهراء حسينا، عهد والله يا زهراء ما ننسى حسينا، عهد والله يا زهراء عهد والله يا زهراء ما ننسى حسينا. اللهم نقسم عليك بمصاب حسين يا الله، عجل لوليك الفرج واجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه والمستشهدين بين يديه يا الله. اللهم تقبل منا هذا القليل واجعله في ميزان حسناتنا، اللهم ارزقنا زيارة الحسين في الدنيا وشفاعته في الآخرة يا الله. اللهم احفظ زوار الحسين، اللهم ارفع هذا البلاء والوباء عن هذا العالم يا الله. اللهم شافي وعافي جميع المرضى لا سيما مرضى المنظورين ومن أوصانا بالدعاء، اللهم اقضي حوائج المحتاجين لا سيما حوائج المستمعين والمشاهدين ومن أوصانا بالدعاء يا الله. اللهم المؤسسين لهذا المأتم الشريف تقبل اللهم أعمالهم ولأمواتهم وأمواتكم وأموات السامعين والجالسين والروح الطاهرة لأبي عبد الله الحسين، نهدي ثواب مجلسنا هذا وثواب سورة المباركة الفاتحة تسبقها صلوات حسينية بأعلى الأصوات. الله.